Hi, I'm Don McIntosh. Welcome back to our program. I'm joined in the studio again with Dr. Neil Nedley. He's the president of Weimar Institute, a practicing internal medicine specialist. And you deal with, you know, people that have underlying conditions that end up in the ICU, your hospitalist. In this COVID virus scare that we're going through, we're trying to boost immunity and whatnot, a lot of segments of society are just kind of being told, look, if you have underlying conditions, you're toast. You know, you're not going to make it. You're old. You got diabetes. That's not really a message of hope. No. Can we give any hope to people that have diabetes? What can they do to robust their immune system?
Absolutely. And it should be mentioned that a lot of people with diabetes have actually survived COVID-19 and severe infections when they come their way. But these are people that are managing their diabetes well. And so to do that, regular aerobic exercise is key. You know, staying off of sugar. Sugar actually suppresses the immune system. It can decrease the ability of a neutrophil to kill a bacteria by about 90% when we're eating, you know, a high sugar diet. And so,
how much exercise?
Exercise, we would recommend a total of 1 hour per day of aerobic exercise. More is even better, but that's kind of minimum as far as getting a nice immune stimulation effect.
Before or after meal?
Sensitivities. It's actually best pre-breakfast.
Okay.
So early morning exercise is the best, but post-meal exercise for, you know, 20, 30 minutes is also good for a diabetic. So if you can do an hour beforehand and maybe a good 20-minute digestive walk after a meal, that's great.
So, and then no refined sugars.
That's right.
And then anything else? What else can we do for diabetics?
Well, we can eat more legumes. Legumes are great for a diabetic. They help gain control, even though they have carbs. They have soluble fiber, and that soluble fiber doesn't produce that blood sugar spike. And so we're able to get our nutrients that way and able to avoid that spike in blood sugar.
So things like lentils, things like beans, things like...
Yes.
Those kind of things.
Yes.
Beans for breakfast, even.
Yes, or black-eyed peas. Mm-hmm. Those work very well even for breakfast. They're more of a sweet legume, and it can be very helpful.
Okay, so that's just basically what we would tell any diabetic to be healthy, but especially during times of infection and whatnot. Anything else they can do?
Well, being out in the sun. You know, sunlight itself is immune stimulatory apart from its effects on vitamin D. And we know vitamin D is very good for our immune system. But since now you can get vitamin D from pills, there have been nice comparison studies showing that when we get our vitamin D from sunlight, it's far more immune enhancing. So getting outdoors, getting that sun through the skin, getting the fresh air, mm-hmm. Getting adequate rest, early to bed, early to rise, gives you a better immune system overall. And then not panicking about things.
Stress makes your blood sugar go up.
Yeah, and it also suppresses the immune system. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people that are diabetics, they are panicking. And, mm-hmm. you know, they're staying indoors. They don't even want to go outside their home. And that's actually going to suppress their immune system. They need outside. Okay. They need to be getting sunlight. They need to be out in fresh air, getting exercise, and having that trust and confidence that staying on a NEWSTART lifestyle, such as Weimar recommends, will actually give them a great sense of security if they happen to come across some bad viruses.
So, I mean, I think that's good news. People are just kind of just tensing up because maybe turn off the TV, go outside, walk, eat the foods that's been suggested, watch this program again, and make a list. And just realize that if you're treating yourself right, you're going to be in good shape. Anything else as we close?
Well, I think I would say the spiritual part is mm-hmm. also important. In fact, there have been studies done showing that when you are a believer and when you have trust in God and when you're having a devotional life, there's a frontal lobe enhancement that actually affects the immune system positively. We call it neuroimmunology. Mm-hmm. And the frontal lobe is actually the control center of the entire immune system. So that frontal lobe enhancement through even hymn singing or devotions or reading the Bible and claiming promises and asking God if you're in compliance with the commands, these are things that are part of that final T, trust in God, it can actually help us in our physical and mental health.
You heard it from the doctor, and I, as the chaplain here at Weimar Institute, totally agree. So let's get out there, let's get that exercise, let's do what's recommended, and I know God's going to bless it.